Jim back and Jim Hackett around there, I mean, is this a chance for a fresh start? Maybe some of the whatever was going on in Michigan in the past that is holding things back. Is this a chance to get a fresh start from some of that stuff?
I don't know if you call it a fresh start. I mean, I would call it a new beginning. We're happy to have Jim here. I think he'll get the support of a lot of former players. You know, not saying that we didn't support. I think a lot of players, quite honest, supported from afar. I mean, because we love Michigan. But I think guys will come back. You'll see more former players. I think Jim will do a lot more for former players and welcome us back. Whether it's practice, not that Brady didn't, he did welcome us back to practice. Because it's going to be a different fit. I mean, I play with the guys, so I feel like I have a personal relationship with them. You know, at least I think I do. I can come and say, hey, Jim, I want to come do this, I want to do that. You know, and he'll listen.
Is that why you felt like you needed to be here today? Because of the relationship?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I felt I needed to be here because I think we're back on track. I mean, I think we got the right guy. We got the guy I think that everybody wanted, or at least most people. I played with him. I know what he stands for. I mean, I went to a Rose Bowl with him, you know, so I know what he's all about.
What's the story you can tell that best demonstrates his intensity and competitiveness?
I mean, Jim was just always fiery in the huddle. You know, guys like to joke around, and once Jim got in the huddle, it was quiet. I mean, he would just say, hey, here's what we're doing, and you do this, and you be quiet. And, you know, he took charge. And I think that can be mistaken sometimes, that a lot of guys think that you have an ego or you know, that it's not represented or not represented well. He just had a lot of confidence. And to be able to take a team to the Rose Bowl and do the things he's done, he has to. I mean, he's a quarterback. And I call it, he has a fine line between ego and confidence, and I like it. I mean, he played at the highest level. I mean, you tell me what quarterback in the NFL doesn't have an ego. I mean, you have to be able to strap it up at that lead, you know, for 16, 18 games a year.
You know, Jim, what are your expectations for what he can do with this team?
My expectation is he's going to bring back that attitude. You know, I mean, you know, people always try to put wins and losses as, you know, how many games do you have to win to be successful in your first year? I think it's about that attitude. You know, I think you're gonna see a different type of Michigan team take the field. You're gonna see an imprint of what he's doing. And, you know, however many games they win. But I think the most important thing is that the kids are learning, that they're going to class, that they're graduating, and we're getting solid guys, not just the best guys all the time. I mean, you look what Michigan State's doing. And, you know, not to say anything negative about anybody, but they've taken three-star. Dan Antonio's done a great job on there. And, you know, those are the guys I think that Michigan used to recruit. I mean, Go used to bring in guys from the city of Detroit and wherever it was and turn them into players. I mean, he took good men, good players, and turned them into great players and great men. And I think that's what Jim's going to get back to.